Hello everyone, welcome back to Placement Prep. Today we are going to discuss MySQL aggregation operators. There are total 5 aggregation functions. Those are average function, minimum function, maximum function, count function and sum function. Starting with the average function, as the name suggests, it is used to calculate the average of all the records of a specified column. We can say that of the selected column. For example, there is one employee table and these are the different column name like employee name, salary and employee ID. If we are writing calculate the average salary of this employee table and within the average function we are specifying the column name as salary. So it will simply return the average of all this salary, like it will return the average of this specified column, that is the salary. Now moving ahead with the syntax of average function, that is select average column name from table name where condition. For example, use an SQL function that calculate the average salary of all the employees from the employee table. So the query will be select average salary from employees. So here it will simply return the average of all the record of the specified column, like the of the selected column. Here we are specifying the column name as the salary, so it will return the average of the salary column. I hope you are clear about the average function. Now moving ahead to minimum function. Minimum function will return, like we'll find out the smallest record among all the records of the selected column. For example, there is one table name, that is employee, and these are the different column name like employee ID, employee name and salary. Suppose we have to find out the minimum, like the smallest of all the records, smallest among all the records from the salary column. We are specifying like from this specified column, from this selected column, find out the smallest record among all these records. So here we can use minimum function. The syntax will be select minimum, then column name that we want to specify, like from where we have to find out the minimum value among all the records, then from table name where condition. For example, calculate or find out the minimum salary of employees from employee table. So the query will be select minimum salary from table, from employees, that is the table name. So this minimum, and we are specifying the column name as salary, so it will go and search like from this salary column which is the smallest record among all this record. I hope you are clear about the minimum function. Now moving ahead to maximum function. Maximum function is just the opposite of minimum function. It will find out the largest record among all the records of the selected column. For example, here suppose the selected column is salary, so it will go and search for the largest record among all this record. So the syntax will be select maximum column name from table name where condition, and the query will be select max salary from employees. So it will go and search, this is the selected column, search for the largest record among all this record. I hope you are clear about the minimum and maximum function. Now moving ahead to the count function. Count function will return the number of rows satisfying a specific condition. The syntax is select count column name from table name where then condition. Suppose there is one query, that is select count asterisk. Here we are writing asterisk, we are not specifying any column name. Asterisk means that we are selecting all the column name. Then from table name, after that we are ending here, we are not specifying any condition. So what this query will return, that is select count asterisk from table name. So it will return all the number of rows from that selected table, cause as we know that count return the number of rows satisfying a specific condition. Here though we are not mentioning any specific condition, so it will return the total number of rows having all those columns. So it will return the total number of rows of that selected table. Moving ahead, suppose there is one table name, that is the customer table, having different column names like customer ID, customer name and contact number. Suppose we are writing the query like select count, we are mentioning the column name as customer ID from customer table, After that, we are ending here not mentioning any specific condition. So this will return the total number of rows having those customer ID. So with customer ID, the total number of rows are 1, 2, 3, 4. So this will return, count customer ID will return 4. Suppose the query here is select count asterisk. We are not mentioning any specific column, we are just selecting all the column name from customer. It will also return 4 because here it will return all the number of rows having those column, like satisfying all those column. As we know that here there are total 4 rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, satisfying all those column, having all those column name. So select count asterisk from customer will also return 4. Now we will discuss some more question with using count function. Like the query is select count customer ID from customers where customer ID equal to 1. Here we are mentioning, like we are specifying a condition, like count customer ID from the customer table where customer ID equal to 1. Like this is the customer table having customer ID, customer name and phone number. Here we are mentioning, like return the number of rows having the customer ID that is equal to 1. Here customer ID with 1, here it is, there is only one value having customer ID 1. So it will return only 1. I hope you are clear about the count function. Now moving ahead to the sum function, sum will return the sum of all values of the selected column. The syntax is select sum column name from table name where condition. Suppose there is one table name that is loan having different column name like cust ID, then BID that is bank ID, then loan amount. The query that is select sum loan amount from loan. This will return the sum of all records from that selected column, that is the loan amount. From this column name, it will return the sum of all records. I hope you are clear about the sum function. If you like this video, please do subscribe to Placement Prep. Thank you. Have a good day.